The Vaccine and Antiviral Prioritization Policy Committee, or VAPPC, held a virtual meeting Thursday afternoon to strategize how they'll be distributing the long-awaited COVID vaccine. Public Health's Annette Uggen held a presentation focused on the committee's key objectives, communication and educational needs, estimated vaccine numbers, as well as what groups will be prioritized, and according to Uggen, the focus on ethics will ensure the fair disbursement of the handful of doses Guam will be receiving.
We are looking at very limited doses as it comes out. And so how can we basically get the most benefit with these limited doses, as it will take several months for us to get more doses? I mean, there's announcements from the federal government that we're looking until maybe summer that we will have enough of our residents immunized.
And while we wait for federal guidance, Uggen says things are subject to change. But as of now, there's a three-phase plan in place.
Phase one is very limited doses are going to come out. Phase two is there'll be a little bit more vaccines available. And then phase three, they anticipate sufficient supply for our nation.
Because the initial shipment of vaccines is so limited, the committee's first phase will be broken down into sub-phases. Phase 1 will cater to healthcare workers and residents of long-term facilities. 1B will be focused on essential workers, and Phase 1C will be geared towards those with comorbidities as well as the elderly, with the general population to be slowly immunized in the latter part of Phase 2 and 3. And according to Uggen, public health will be sharing the workload with local clinics.
We have more than 20 private partners in the healthcare sector that have signed up, and they're going to help us by immunizing their population, their patients in their facilities, while public health is doing like what's considered the mass vaccination. So again, it's a community-wide effort.
With many members in the community serving in the Guam National Guard, Uggen confirms that immunization will be a joint effort.
We've reached out to them as well for the information request on prioritization within their workforce. And so yes, it'll be a combination of what they receive through the DOD and then what the health department will provide to them as well.
With a large portion of the department's workforce focused on COVID response and testing, Public Health Director Art St. Augustine says they'll need to move some people around, but he's confident they'll be ready.
We're pretty much positioning ourselves for its eventual arrival and continually reviewing to make sure that we're positioned, working with our team to advise them that once the vaccines are here, we're going to have to reposition our resources so that it's not just this last minute approach, but they've already been informed, so they're ready to reposition as they need to.
Reporting for Guam's News Network, I'm Peter Santos.